moment. Satyapal Jain, you may have caught what Mukul Rohtgi said. He said he's very surprised that 3 weeks after what the NCB has come out with in this case, Aryan Khan is still in jail. Your response, particularly because you've also been a politician and the Maharashtra government is now saying this entire case is politically motivated. Sir, you're mute. You're on mute. You're on mute, sir.
Mr. Rajdeep Sardesai,
yes.
NDPS, it is a special act. Yes. It lays down the procedure for investigation, arrest, registration, etc., etc., etc. In the present case, the so-called accused, who are accused according to the NCB, have been arrested, produced before the court. They have been sent to the judicial custody and they have been denied bail by a legally competent judicial court. They have not been denied bail by the NCB. Under Section 37
yes.
of the NDPS Act, a bail can be granted to any accused if the court is satisfied that he is not guilty of such offence and that he is not likely to commit any offence while on bail. This is a special provision in addition to the earlier condition of bail granted by the CRPC. What I am saying is this. Kindly go through the order passed by the learned special judge. 18-19 page order.
Yes.
Where he has discussed all the points raised by Mr. Very learned counsel, senior colleague, just now Mr. Mukul Rohtgi. The court has recorded a finding that there seems to be an international record. The courts recorded a finding that it is not possible to record that he is not guilty of the offence. And secondly, I say even if the special judge has gone wrong, they have gone to the High Court. It's a judicial process. Why are you blaming the NCB? NCB has tried him, arrested him, produced mm-hmm. before the court, and it is he is in the judicial custody. But what are you blaming the political person, political personality?
No, that
are you going to have two laws?
You're
two
saying,
laws for different citizens.
You're saying,
country?
If at all, question the order of the special judge. Don't question. You're saying the NCB is doing what it is doing under the NDPS. It is the judge who has to interpret the case. Biswajit Bhattacharya, another former additional solicitor general joining us. Biswajit Bhattacharya, your reactions. Do you believe that the real questioning that has to now be done over is the way judges are interpreting the law under NDPS? We've got this new doctrine of conscious possession, which really can open the floodgates. Someone sitting next to me at a party is consuming drugs. I will be accused of conscious possession tomorrow.
In fact, by the same logic of the Honorable Court, the entire crew should have been arrested. And, I was just glancing through the, judgment. Mm-hmm. Accused number one and accused number two basically traveled together. Mm-hmm. So therefore, it's a criminal conspiracy. And although nothing is recovered from accused number one, mm-hmm. And, if this is the kind of perception which our very, very robust judicial system adopts, mm-hmm. and, why three persons, accused number one, two, and three, mm-hmm. when 6 grams of charas and 5 grams of hashish have allegedly been recovered from two and three, and nothing from one, just to make a sort of criminal conspiracy and all that, why common judgment has been written?
No, Mr. Bhattacharya, by the WhatsApp chats. They are saying the WhatsApp chats reveal possibly enough reason to have further investigation. That's why today they've gone to this actor Ananya Pandey's residence. They need, they're saying, time, and they fear that being the son of a VVIP, he can destroy evidence.
Now, where is the evidence which can be destroyed?
The WhatsApp chats, presumably.
See, the question of destroying evidence will arise only when the investigating agencies arrive and basically find some evidence. Hmm. There is, apart from, from accused number one, there is no recovery whatsoever. There is no evidence. Where is to destroy? And, this pet sentence, that they are going to tamper with evidence, destroying the investigation, commit the same offense events. It will have international ramification. They have talked to a foreign national. Rajdeep, my fundamental objection to this judgment is, why three separate judgments could not have been written, one for accused number one, one for accused number two, and one for accused number three. Is it because of the fact that the learned court had to write they are inseparable, they cannot be separated? Now, if you write three separate judgments, it will be very difficult to, you know, say, prove whatever has been articulated. Besides the power of arrest, you know, Rajiv, arrest jurisprudence and remand jurisprudence, I'm afraid this judicial system, the public prosecutor, the courts, it has to undergo a metamorphosis. Otherwise,
let me take that very point to you, Mr. Satyapal Jain, in conclusion, that, you know, the principle was settled, bail not jail, but particularly in NDPS, and we saw it last year even in the Riya Chakrabarty case. I mean, she was not even found with drugs again on, she had no possession of drugs. The best accusation against her was that she was, in a way, procuring drugs for her boyfriend, and yet she spent a month in jail. The question I ask you, Satyapal Jain, are judges in these high-profile cases reluctant, particularly in lower courts, to grant bail in the first instance?
No. I don't agree with you at all. See, there have been cases where the so-called celebrities have been granted bail at the very initial stage. Salman Khan's case, where in appeal, only on the ground that the judgment, copy of the judgment was not available, he was granted bail. I want to make two points. Number one, NCB has produced all relevant evidence before the court, and court records it. WhatsApp chats, WhatsApp conversations have been produced before the court. These statements recorded have also been produced before the court. Third, the matter is still under investigation. The investigation is not complete. And second point which I want to make to all the concerned people is, these are the special acts. NDPS is a special act. PMLA is a special act. Under CRPC, there is no condition that you will not grant bail to a person unless the court records a finding that he is not guilty of the offence. Under this act, section 37, the court will grant you bail only, the act says, which is a special act, if the court comes to the conclusion that he is not guilty of the offence and that he is not likely to commit any other offence. Now, this order, just one thing more, just one. The order takes care of all the judgments cited by both the parties. It's a detailed order. Now, why three judgments have not been passed? Why one judgment has been passed? Had the lawyers pressed that pass separate orders, the court would have passed the separate order also. And this doesn't vitiate the order. Simply because the three applications in the same case have been
vitiated. The order.
Doesn't vitiate. And if it is vitiated, the court will go to the High Court. The High Court is hearing this matter. Let me take a decision.
Gentlemen. Let's not, because the fact is the laws under NDPS do make it more difficult to grant bail, particularly Section 37, as you mentioned, Satyapal Jain. The question, of course, that I asked at the very outset, is the evidence prima facie of a kind that really justifies 3 weeks at the moment?